Aluminum cans. You might know them as shelf-to-mouth delivery vessels for various liquids. But take a close look at the International Space Station or the Lunar Gateway. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
It's all soda and beer cans. Like seriously, you only have to take a module and scale up its branding and you get something almost indistinguishable from a soda can. And this begs the question, why?
Why
do space modules look like soda cans? Well, one reason has to do with rockets. And the other reason has to do with nuclear submarines capable of nuking the entirety of North America. But more about that later. Because first, we have to talk about rockets, specifically their limits, weight and volume. The weight a rocket can shoot up into orbit is limited by the power of the rocket's engines and by the amount of fuel the rocket has. And the volume a rocket can carry is limited by the size of the rocket's fairing. That's this thing. Those limits restrict what we can shoot up into space. Shooting up a small obese dwarf? Easy peasy. But shooting up a huge ass inflated bouncy house is a different story. It's lightweight, but it just won't fit.
That's what she said!
And speaking of houses, a space module is a house. It's not a bouncy house, not a hobo's house, but an astronaut's house. And we all know one thing. Bigger house, better house. So for our space module, we want to use up as much of the available volume as possible to maximize property value, while at the same time trying to keep our module as lightweight as possible. Otherwise, our rocket will go up, run out of fuel because the module is too heavy, and crash back down again. Or the rocket won't lift off at all, resulting in a quite depressing rocket launch. So, how do we maximize volume while minimizing weight so that that doesn't happen? The answer is balls. Round, spherical balls. Because balls use the least amount of material for a given volume, making them the most weight-efficient shape out there. And because balls don't have corners, they are also great at dealing with pressure, because the pressure uniformly stresses the walls, unlike a cube, whose edges are weak points needing to be strengthened to withstand high pressures. Pussy. This makes balls the perfect shape for space modules, soda cans and submarines. The hulls can be lightweight while still being strong enough to withstand high pressures. And what's fascinating, at least to me, is that the badass space module, in the deadly vacuum of endless space, has to deal with less pressure difference than a soda can. A freaking ordinary soda can. And speaking of soda cans, you've probably noticed that neither space modules nor soda cans or submarines look like that. That would be silly. In reality, they are not balls, but cylinders. And there's a good reason for that, because cylinders are Cronenberg monsters made out of balls and cuboids. I mean, have you ever drank out of a coconut? It's nice, but put the coconut on table and it will roll off, spilling white sticky fluid everywhere, causing your stepmom to think that you played around with your new shepherd.
Horny shmorny, hmm?
And if that's not already bad enough, you have the inefficiency problem when storing balls. Because if packed as closely as possible, only 74% of the total volume is taken up by the balls. That's sh**. It's sh** for transporting soda cans, and it's sh** for transporting a space module to space. Cylinders are way better in that regard. They take up 91% of the total volume when packed as closely as possible. They don't roll around, and they fit quite nicely into rocket fairing, wasting less volume than a ball, making a cylinder basically a better ball. From the top, it's like a ball, hence having the attributes of a ball. And from the side, it's like a cuboid, somewhat eliminating the downsides of a ball. It's freaking genius, and that's why we see cylinders everywhere where we have something to deal with pressures efficiently, whether it's soda cans, submarines, space modules, or even rockets. And if you still aren't convinced that cylinders are S-tier waifu material, let's take a detour to the sexy topic of manufacturing. Balls are sh** to manufacture. Just take a piece of paper and try folding it into a hollow ball. It's not fun. Manufacturing a cylinder, on the other hand, is pretty easy. Once the piece is folded, you slap some caps at the end and you are golden. This makes cylinders less expensive to manufacture compared to balls, at a low cost of manufacturing to the points discussed before, and it should be clear why space modules look like soda cans. It's because cylinders are just...